friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear.
Safe side, kind of like some indigestion, so I'm going to stay away from you folks. You know, I'm not feverish, you know, I'm just a little bit of an upset stomach, and I told him the story behind it.
You overdone Oreos.
Oh, no.
That's close.
Yeah, I'd eaten a couple sandwiches that had maybe been sitting out for a while, so.
Oh, that might be.
Maybe. I don't know. It could have just been, you know, something that just didn't agree with me. I know that after the time, and I'm feeling better now than when I came to church. So it's just that you just don't know these days with the sickness. This morning, Dave and Linda and Crowbar are not with us. They're feeling fine, but they were around some family this past week that had COVID. So to be on the safe side, they said we'll stay and keep our distance from folks. And I says, okay, I get it. Understand. I don't know that I've been around anybody that's had it. Of course, nobody does know.
Right.
You just don't know anymore. So, but at any rate, if I seem like a stranger to you today, it's because I am. Will you? Okay.
All right.
Take our chances.
Yeah, my stomach is feeling more settled. I think that it was something that I ate. It probably didn't help much this morning because I went ahead with my usual breakfast with orange juice. Figured I needed the nutrition. But at any rate, it's good to see you this morning. And our prayers do go out to the Delaney family. Taking a look at our bulletin, and I've got to get to the right bulletin here. Oh, I've got it here. Okay, there it is. Keep the Delaney family prayer. We also had on our prayer list Ruth Ann Yost. She passed away. We'll keep the Yost family in prayer. And, of course, the Morris family. I did the funeral this past Monday for Danny Morris, the young man that was killed in the accident down at the mill. That was sad. He was only 42 years of age. And had really worked hard on getting his life put back together. And just tragic. So there are people around us that are grieving, and we do need to pray for them, that the Lord will help to comfort their hearts. Looking down the list, I'll give you just a quick report of my dad. My dad this past week, he's been mowing his grass for some time with a riding mower. He called me the other day and he says, not only did I do the riding mower because I've been doing the push mowing, he says, I got the push mower out and did the trimming with the push mower. So he's continuing to make progress. Very thankful. Thank you for your prayers. You may want to note that Aaron McCauley, the third name there, he's going to be having a neck surgery, and it's not until September the 21st. Kind of perplexed about this. It's a tumor that's growing on his neck, and it's going to be another month and a half before he's able to have that surgery. So just keep him in prayers. Kathy, it's listed as Curdy. It should be McCurdy, McCurdy. That's April Wells' grandmother, and she's recovering from a stroke, and it's kind of a slow process. Continue to pray for her. Also, I'll report that two-thirds of the way down Ron Mock, I saw his son this past week, his son Jay, and he said that Ron, his dad, is just not doing well with his cancer. Ask prayer for him. Sherry Miller, that's right near the bottom of the first column, she had to have her leg scraped. She had an infection in it, and she had been in an accident, and apparently has had some complications, and she needs her prayers. Looking in the last column, Bill Thrasher, the fifth name down, he's not doing real well with his cancer. That's Sherrod Pardee's brother. So we pray for Bill Thrasher. Also, down near the bottom of that last column, Nicole Sims. This was the co-worker friend of April Wells that got beat with a tire iron, and she's trying to recover. April did text me this past week that Nicole had taken a couple steps. She's still on a feeding tube, but she's going to have to learn to eat and talk and walk and everything got a long journey in front of her. We need to add to our prayer list Mary Beth Robinson. We've had her on our prayer list before. This is Tony Sue Daugherty's sister. Mary Beth has been in the hospital, was ready to get discharged this past week, and they tested her and she tested positive for COVID. So she's got to spend another week or 2 weeks in the hospital. And then last but not least, we'll pray for all the people with COVID. Thankfully, it doesn't seem to be as potent as it was, you know, a couple years ago, but still, there's a lot of it out there, and pray that we could eventually get to where we don't have to deal with it. So those are the prayer requests. I don't know if you've got additional names or needs to mention or not. Unspoken. Okay. All right, well, let's pray together, okay? Father, we've come into your house. I'm very grateful that we can be here. As Chuck talked about down in Kentucky, we've seen images of what people down there have been through. I don't know what church buildings were affected there, but we're grateful that we still have ours. There have been so many people that have lost homes and such loss of life, I think. Last count was like 37 or something. Father, we've been blessed. We come into your house this morning to say thank you for blessing us. It's not us, our place to question, but we wonder why, Father, you've allowed this to happen and so many people to be hurt. But, Father, you know all things, and all that we can do is just ask for your mercy to be upon these people as they try to pull their lives back together. For those that are grieving, that, Lord, you comfort their hearts. For those that have lost property, that, Lord, you help them with rebuilding, that you'll be with the workers that come in to try to help. And then we look at Kentucky, and then we, as Chuck said, you look out in California with fires that are going on. And Father, there's problems all around the world. And so as we come to your house this morning, it is with gratitude that we can come here and thank you for the blessings that we have. Thank you for our health. As we go through this prayer request list every week, it's a reminder to us of how blessed we are. Our names could be on there. We're thankful that you've given us the health and strength that we can still get out. So many of these people here are not able to go. And we just ask you, Lord, to please have mercy and touch and heal these people and restore health and strength. But we come, Father, not only to thank you for the temporal blessings. These are blessings that are temporary. Father, our health, while it may be good today, it could be bad tomorrow. And Father, the homes and the jobs that we have today may be safe, but they could be gone tomorrow. But we thank you, Father, most of all for those eternal blessings. The eternal blessing of being one of your children and knowing that you've got a place prepared for us. The eternal blessing of knowing that you've said you'd never leave us and you'd never forsake us. The promise that your Son is living, or your Spirit is living within our hearts and lives to guide us and to teach us. So we come to your house today grateful for blessings, certainly grateful for the temporal blessings, but grateful for the eternal blessings of being your children and knowing that no matter what happens, you've got us safely in your care. We come and we say thank you. We thank you for answers to prayer. I know that I've often reported on my dad. I'm so grateful for what you've done for my dad. And just pray, Father, that you continue to strengthen him, but grateful too for what you've done for others. As we go down our prayer list, Father, there's so many that are doing much better. Even this Nicole Sims, that after she got beat with that tire iron, there was real concern about whether or not she would even make it. And yet she's showing promise of progress, and we give you thanks. We pray your continued blessing. So we come to you, Father, with these needs, and I'm not going to go through all of them, but we ask you, Father, to please help these people. At the top of our list, we have grieving families. Know that I did a funeral for the Daniel Morris family this past week, and trust the Lord that you continue to comfort them. Ruth Ann Yost, who was put on our prayer list, she passed away, and our prayers are with the family to comfort them. But tomorrow, I do the funeral service for Norma Delaney. Pray, Father, that you'll comfort the family. Norma was such an inspiration to her family and loved by everyone, and a woman of deep faith. And I just pray, Father, that you might help family at this time to hold on to your promises, to know that while Norma is no longer with us, she's now in your presence. So comfort those that are grieving. Touch those, Father, that have all sorts of sicknesses and diseases and illnesses and injuries, that, Father, your hand of healing might be upon them to restore health and strength to them. Please encourage their hearts. Help them not to give up. Help them to look up and to keep trusting in you. We pray even for the unspoken request. Father, sometimes there's things that we just really don't want to talk about with others. And Lord, we bring those to you and we ask for your help. May you even be Lord of those situations in such a way that you will be honored and your name will be praised. We do pray for our country. We pray for our leaders, Lord, that you would please give our leaders wisdom and help, Father, our country to get turned back to you. We pray for revival, Father, that people might be prompted by your spirit to come back in your house of worship and humble themselves and say, you know what, we've got a lot of problems, but we know that God can turn things around if we will just humble ourselves before him. We pray for revival. We pray for those that are lost that they might come under conviction and see their need to get saved. We pray, Father, for our security. We pray for our military and law enforcement that you bless them and their families and keep them safe. And Father, we just pray that you might help us as your people grow closer to you every day. Father, forgive us for the many things that we do that are wrong, and help us to grow to become more like your Son. Please bless the remainder of our time together. Use the message that you've laid on my heart, Father, to encourage us to keep working at being the person that you've called us to be. Father, I know that sometimes it's frustrating because it seems like we never become all that we need to be. And quite honestly, I know that we never will be. Your word teaches that until we get in your presence. But let that not discourage us. Help us to continue to model our lives after your Son, Jesus Christ, and use us to be a blessing. We love you, Father, and we thank you so much for being our God. Just continue to hold us close and guide us to do your will.